Sometimes it's difficult to know if the Lewis structure that you have created is actually the correct Lewis structure, especially if you can come up with more than one structure. So there's something called the formal charge check, where you go through the structure and check the formal charge on each atom in the structure. Now, the formula for formal charge is that the formal charge on each atom is equal to the number of valence electrons on that atom minus the sum of the lone electrons on that particular atom plus the bonding number of bonds on that atom. Sometimes the formula is written that way. Sometimes it's written as the number of valence electrons on the atom minus the sum of the lone electrons plus one half the shared electrons, because in each bond there are two electrons. Either formula, they're both the same. You can pick whichever one makes more sense to you. I tend to use this one. Okay, so and the rule states that the formal charge on each atom should be minimized. That is as close to zero as possible. And the sum of the formal charge on each atom in the structure should be equal to the charge on that compound. So if you have a neutral compound, the formal charges all have to add up to be zero. But if you have a polyatomic anion or a polyatomic cation, the formal charges need to add up to be the charge on that particular polyatomic anion or cation. Let's look at an example. Here's a compound, COH2. That's formaldehyde. It's a compound called formaldehyde. Formaldehyde. Okay. First of all, let's do the S equals N minus A rule to figure out how many bonds we should have in this particular compound. So S equals N minus A. N is the number needed. Okay, we've got one carbon, one oxygen, and two hydrogens. Each carbon needs eight electrons to satisfy its octet. Each oxygen needs eight electrons to satisfy its octet. And each hydrogen only needs two electrons. So the sum of the needed electrons here is 16 plus 4 is 20 electrons. Next, let's look at the available electrons. So we have one carbon. Carbon is in group 4 of 14. So there are four valence electrons in carbon. Oxygen is in group 6 or 16, so there's six electrons. Hydrogen is in group 1, so there is one electron. So the available electrons here is 4 plus 6 is 10 plus 2 is 12 electrons available to work with in this structure. All right, the next thing you do is you write out the skeletal structure connecting each atom. So in this case, we have carbon bound to oxygen, bound to hydrogen. Hydrogen's always terminal, so I'll put the hydrogen on either end. Okay, that's one way to put it together. Another way to put this structure together would be to put carbon and put a hydrogen bound directly to the carbon, a hydrogen bound directly to the carbon, and an oxygen bound here. In both cases, we've used 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6. Six of our available 12 electrons. The next rule says place the remaining electrons on the terminal atoms. Of course, hydrogen can't have any more. Hydrogen can't have any more. Carbon's first, so that's our central atom. So oxygen must be a terminal. So it can take two. So for this case, we've used 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, but we had 12 available electrons. So the rule says if you've placed electrons everywhere, the central atom still isn't satisfied, place two electrons on the central atom. In this case, 2, 4, 6, we have six more electrons to use. So we put 2, 4, 6 electrons on that terminal atom. The hydrogens can't take any. All right, the next rule says that if the central atom still isn't satisfied and you've used up all of your electrons, take a pair of electrons from a terminal atom and form a multiple bond to satisfy the octet. So we'd have to take this here and make hydrogen, Okay. All right. And a double bond here. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. We've used all of our electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have made 4 bonds. How many bonds should we make here? Let's see. 20 minus 12. I forgot to finish that. Is 8. So 8 divided by 2 equals 4 bonds. We expect 4 bonds from the S equals N minus A rule here. So we 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 bonds there. And here, this still isn't satisfied, so we need to move a pair. And so in this structure, we have, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8. We've satisfied the carbon. 10, 12, we've used all of our electrons. We have 4 bonds. So both of these structures match our S equals N minus A rule, and we followed all the rules. Which is the better structure? In this case, we're going to have to do the formal charge check. And so what you do is you calculate the formal charge on each atom in the compound. Okay, so formal charge on the carbon here is going to be the formal charge formula. I'll rewrite it right up here. The formal charge formula is the formal charge is equal to the valence minus the lone electrons plus the number of bonds. All right, and so in this case, the valence for carbon is 4 minus the lone electrons, there's 2 plus the bonds. So that's a minus 1 formal charge there. For this hydrogen, it is 1 minus 0 plus 1, that's 0. The other one is the same thing. 1, 0 plus 1 is 0. And then for the oxygen here, right here, we have 6 is the valence electrons minus 2 lone electrons plus 1, 2, 3 bonds. That is equal to positive 1. Okay? And so if you add up all of the formal charge there, the total sum is 0. That's what we expect. Now let's check the formal charge on this compound. We'll do it right here. So it is going to be for the carbon, it's going to be 4 minus 0 plus 4 bonds is equal to 0. For the ox or for the hydrogen, the left hydrogen, it's 1 minus 0 plus 1 is 0. 1 minus 0 plus 1 is 0. And for the oxygen up here, it's 6 minus 1, 2, 3, 4 lone electrons plus 2 bonds equals 0, the sum being 0. The rule for the formal charge is that you want to minimize the formal charge on every atom. That is, get it closest to 0 as possible. This one, there are values for two of them. The carbon has a minus 1 and the oxygen has a 0, excuse me, a plus 1. That's bad because it's not 0, and it's even worse because oxygen is more electronegative. So if there were going to be a formal charge, I would expect the oxygen to have the negative 1 and the carbon to have the positive 1. So because the formal charge check tells me so, this is the better Lewis structure.